Aprons protect cooks from splatters and are handy for wiping hands. But as Weekend Edition essayist Bonnie Wolf knows, aprons also play a less tangible role in life.
Back when she was a toddler, my neighbor Phoebe would visit me every day, go straight to the kitchen, pull my apron down from its hook, and hand it to me. She seemed to think I was incomplete without it. She was right. Just as Phoebe couldn't go to bed without her large, flop-eared rabbit, I couldn't go to the kitchen without my apron. I don't remember when I started wearing an apron. It was probably when I got married 30 years ago. An apron then seemed to be a sign of being settled and grown up. When a friend got married around the same time, the woman who lived next door made her 7 gingham cross-stitched aprons, one for each day of the week. Another friend of the same vintage says when she got married, her West Texas grandmother made her an orange, ruffled hostess apron with matching potholder. But aprons have their genesis in, well, Genesis. After Adam and Eve ate the forbidden fruit, and when they noticed they were naked, they sewed fig leaves together and made, what else would you call them? Aprons. Cooks, blacksmiths, butchers, carpenters, and bakers have since worn aprons to protect their clothes. Even George Washington wore an apron. It was made of white lambskin, the symbol of a master mason. My friend Stephanie's 2 grandfathers were buried in their mason's aprons. By the 1950s, form did not always follow function. Example, the hostess apron, a peculiar accessory made of things like organdy, taffeta, and sequins that was worn for fancy parties. But when women began to spend less time at home and more time at the office, a kitchen apron became a symbol of female servitude. I remember coming home from a long day at work, putting on my apron, and feeling politically incorrect. Still, for me, an apron has always been empowering. The dictionary defines an apron as a garment fastened in the back, worn to protect clothing. True. But I like the second meaning, a protective shield. So every morning, wearing my workout clothes or maybe still in my bathrobe, I go into the dark kitchen and I put on my apron. Before I have coffee, before I look at the paper, before I quiet the barking dog. Wearing my armor, I'm ready to face the day.
Essayist Bonnie Wolf ties her apron strings in her kitchen in Washington, D.C. When I walk.